In today's class, I'm going to explain about types of selectors in CSS, which is also called the types of CSS selectors. Then I will discuss one by one in today's class. There are five types of the selectors in CSS. The first one is element selector. Then second one is ID selector. The third one is class selector. Fourth one is what is called group selector. Then fifth one is universal selector. But why we use these selectors in CSS? The selectors can be used to select a particular element in HTML document where you want to add the styles. Okay, if you want to add the styles to a particular element in the HTML document, we go for any one of the selectors. And it depends on your application, you can choose a correct selector to add the styles to your HTML document. Then what is the element selector? Okay, you can able to select the element by name. Okay, here the ID selector, it is the attribute which will be used in the opening tag of any element. Okay, you can add the styles to the ID of the element. Then here also, instead of ID, we could able to use the class selectors. We can able to add the styles to the class selector. Class selector is the attribute of the any particular element. Group selector, then I will explain you with help of the example group selector. Okay, then how do we group the selectors? The group the selector by using the comma. The universal selector also I will explain with help of the example. Then direct I move on to the example. First of all, I want to explain about the element selector. Then what is element selectors? Okay, the tag is also called as element selector. Here the structure of the HTML document, you know it. Directly I will go for right. Suppose I want to use some paragraph. Then I want to, this is first paragraph. First paragraph. Then I am also using the second. Just I will second. I want to use the two paragraphs. This is second paragraph. Then close. I also award some H1 or H2 tags over here. H1 tag or H3, whatever the tag we want to use. This is heading tag. We see here how many elements are used in the HTML document. Then three elements are used in the HTML document. Then if you want to add the styles to which element in the HTML document, you should select the element by using the name. Then you should write within the head tag and also within the style tag. What are the styles you want to add to the HTML elements? Then you can write it within the style tag in the head. Okay, the head tag will be open, the head tag will be closed. Then I want to add the styles. Okay, then how do you add the style? By using the name of the element. What is the name of the element? Here the paragraph tag. Then which style do you want to add? Then I want to add the text align center, and also I would like to use the color of the text should be changed. Then color of text should be a green. Here you are adding styles to the element name P. Okay, what are the P elements are there in your HTML document which is applicable? Then here I did not add any styles to the tag H3. Then just you save it. Then refresh this page. Here you can see this is the heading tag. There is no such styles as to be added to the heading tag. Then because we are adding the color to the first paragraph, the second paragraph, two styles as to be added. The first center, it will be displayed in the center. Then also the text color has changed to green. Yeah, if you want to add the styles to the H1 also, you can able to use here the H1. Sir, what is the tag you used there? H3. Then what? Suppose color should be. Then suppose medium blue. Then text align also would be changed. Center. Then save it. Then refresh this page. Yeah. The heading tag has also been changed. This color has displayed with blue. Then paragraph has displayed with the green color. This is for what we would like to use the element selector. We could able to select the elements by using the element selector. Then I would like to go for the ID selector. We could able to select the elements by using the ID attribute. Okay, ID is the attribute. You should be using ID equal. Then demo one. Here suppose ID equal demo two. Here suppose ID equal to demo 3. Here the ID attribute we are using, the ID equal demo 1, ID equal demo 2, ID equal demo 3. But how do you add the styles to the particular attribute? Particular ID attribute. Then before the ID attribute, how do you add the styles to the ID attribute? You should use the hash character followed by the name of the ID. Hash character. What is the hash character? Here hash should be used, then followed by the then demo 1. Then here also you would like to use hash character, then followed by the suppose demo 2. Got it? Then how do you add the styles to the ID attribute? What is the syntax to add the styles? Then you should able to use the first hash character, then followed by the name of the ID. What is the name of the ID? Is here demo 1. Then hash character followed by the demo 1. Then demo 2. How do you add the styles to the demo? Hash character demo 2. Then I did not add any styles to the demo 3. Got my point? Then we will check it once. Then save it. Then refresh the page. Got it? Because we are adding the styles to the demo 1, demo 2. I did not add any styles to the what is called demo 3. The normal text as displayed with the black color, it is aligned at the left of the window. I did not add any style. Please look at here. This is called as what? ID attribute. Okay, what are the styles do you want to add to the elements by using the ID attribute? How do you add the styles? By using the hash character followed by the name of the ID. Here, if you want to add the styles to the demo 3, you can also use demo 3. Then what do you want? Then I would like to change text align center. Then I would like to change the background color. What is the background color? Suppose red. Suppose Indian red. Then refresh it. Yeah. This is heading tag. This is first. We are also added to the third ID attribute. And then what are the styles do you want to add by using the ID attribute? We can use it by selecting the ID attribute. Is it clear? Then I will go for the class attribute. Then what is the class attribute? Then instead of using the ID attribute, we go for the class. Then class equal demo 1. Then class equal to demo 2. Then class. Here also I would like to use demo 1. Demo 1, demo 2. Here the H3 class equal to demo 1, P class equal to demo 1, then P class equal to demo 2. Then how to add the styles to the class attributes to HTML elements by using the class attribute. Whenever the class is there, how do you styles? Then we should be able to use the first character as a dot or period character, which is also called a period character or dot. Then here also you can use, instead of as character, we could able to use then dot. Dot demo 1, dot demo 2. Then check it once. The same styles as added. Okay. Then same demo 1. For example, here the H3 class equal demo 1, P class equal to demo 2. I don't want to add the styles to the second demo 1. I want to add the styles to the first demo 1. Then what should you do? Then before that, which you want to add the styles to the unique element. I don't want to add the styles to the all the class attributes. Then what you have to do at that time? Here, before that, you could able to use which one H3 are class equal demo 1, class equal demo 1. Two are there here. Then we either you go for the H3 element or P element, then I would like to use the H3 dot demo 1. Here, what are the styles you are adding, which is applicable to the only H3, not for the paragraph tag. Then we will check it once. Got it? Here, the second paragraph, there is no such styles as to be added to the second paragraph. We added the styles to the only first paragraph. This is heading tag. Please check it once over here. This is called a class selectors. The ID selector, the class selector, which are very important for designing any such website. Please listen carefully. If you have any doubt regarding this, please connect me through chat box or comment box, either or a mail. Okay. Then this is called as, here this simple example for about the what is called class selectors. Okay, element selector has completed, the ID selector has completed, the class selector has completed. Then we go for the group selectors. Here also I would like to use the green. Here the same attribute I would like to use here. Here, H2. H4, here also H4, then I would like to change all these, don't want to use any attributes which are completed already. This is second heading tag. I would like to use here control X and H4. The H3, H4, then here also H3, H4, then paragraph. Here also I want to use the element selectors. I want to add the styles to the all H3, H4, P. The same kind of styles we are adding, the text and center color green for H3, the text and center color green for H4, then text and center color green for the P. Then we would like to see this is the heading tag, this is second heading tag, this is all these as displayed in the green color. But instead of writing the individual style declaration, we go for the group selector. When we go for the group selector, the same kind of styles we are adding to the all the elements. Instead of writing the separate statements, we go for the group selectors. When we use the group selectors, then we need to what is called override the redundant code. Here same duplication of the code for the H3, the same code we are using for H4, the same code we are using for the paragraph. Then instead of writing these three, we could group the all the elements into a single one. Then how it is possible? Then I want to remove these two. Then simply, how do you group them? By using the group selector separated by comma. Each and every element or selector is separated by comma. H3, then H4, then P. Then same kind of declaration you can applicable to the elements. Instead of writing the separate selectors or separate declaration, we go for the group selector. At that time, we can also reduce the number of lines. Then H3, H4 paragraph, the text aligned center, the color green. At that time, thus we can see how same output we will get it. Any change is there? The same, because instead of writing the separate selectors, we need to go for the group selectors for same kind of styles we are adding to the elements. Got it? This is called what is called group selectors. Got it? Then each and every selectors are elements separated by comma, that is called as the group selector. Then universal selectors. Then how do we go for the universal selector? What are the styles we are adding, which is applicable to all the elements? Then here, instead of using this one because star, I would like to use the background color. See here, star, then asterisk, whatever you want. Star means this is called an universal. Because there is no such elements to be used, then just instead of mentioning the element name or attribute name or class name, then simply we could able to use star character. Then what are the styles we are adding, which is applicable to all the elements of HTML document. All the elements of HTML documents. Then we will save it, then refresh the page. We check it once. See here, this is heading tag. This is heading tag, the second heading tag, this is first graph paragraph. We also added the background color of web page. Got it? This is, if you want to, what are the styles you are adding to the entire the document, not for the particular element, then we go for universal selector. Okay, when you design the web page, if you want to left margin, right margin, top margin, then we go for the, at that time, we go for the universal selector while you are designing the web page or website. Then here, these are the types of the selectors in CSS. If you have any doubt regarding this example, please ask me at any time through WhatsApp or comment box window. Thank you. Thank you one and all for watching my videos.